After spending most of their lives battling alcoholism, violence and crime, these men are facing the biggest challenge of their lives. With support of the Strongbala program, they're ready to fight, but this time without their fists.
And like any other person around here, you know, like a real alcoholic, binge drinking, fighting, going to prison.
The Strongbala program has had a big impact on lives of Aboriginal men in Katherine. But what's their secret? Why does it work where others fail?
Being able to talk to the people, you know, and for the people to listen to you and trust you, you know, that's where it all comes from. And it comes back to what we used to call crowbar counselling. Crowbar counselling is working with the men in the field and just talking with them, you know, and just having a yarn.
But despite their success, the program is at risk of closing due to federal government budget cuts.
It's a shame that, you know, we only have a year's funding left with us, but you know, we've got to provide results. We just can't stop there, I suppose. We've just got to do what we're doing and do it better and improve and you know, show our funding bodies that yes, you know, we are achieving results.
And for guys who are engaged in the program, finding a space where they can talk and heal is much better than the alternative, prison.
I used to do that all the time. Years ago, I used to just get into art because it was a good way to express myself without being violent. And I mean, a lot of my pictures are violent. And it's just a lot of fantasy art, you know, just but whatever's in my head. And it's better to try and put things on paper in a different perspective instead of just physically getting in there and, you know.
Listen to, you know, your mothers, your elders and stuff like that. Try to keep out of trouble, get into sports. Try to keep your mind occupied and stay away from people that get into trouble and stuff like that.
Denny Tees Johnson in Katherine for NITV News.